You're watching Adjuster TV.
Hey IAs, today I want to talk to you about some industry trends that I'm noticing, some things I'm concerned about and I want to keep you informed about so you can make better decisions in your IA career. Hey IAs, and welcome to the Auto IA Show by IA Path. At IA Path, we help new IAs get the experience requirement waived with over 20 companies through our 90-day online mentorship program. If you're interested, head over to iapath.com. As I mentioned in the opener, there are some trends that I'm concerned about. As we enter into the summer of 2020, on the tail end of COVID, there are some things we need to talk about that are happening. In the last 7 days, I've heard it mentioned twice about this particular trend I want to make you aware about, and I think it's in your best interest to pay attention. Now, what is this trend? What's going on, and how's it going to affect you? Here's the trend. Independent adjusters, auto damage appraisers, wearing shorts, t-shirts, and flip-flops to inspections. You gotta be kidding me. Look at me, I'm pouring sweat, but I'm dressed right, right? Summer's hot, but we can't wear just anything to inspections. And as IAs, not only do you represent you in your business, but guess what? Your reflection on all independent adjusters. So I feel like I need to come out and talk a little bit about this and make sure we're all on the same page here, because your bad reputation ultimately affects me and the other IAs in the industry. My bad reputation affects you and the other IAs in the industry. So it's good for us to come together and say, hey, we're running our own business. We like our careers. We want to keep doing this. And if the insurance companies quit trusting us with their claims, quit trusting us to go look at their insured's vehicle, quit trusting us with their brand to represent them as we go do an inspection, we're not gonna get any more work. They're gonna find another way. So you need to think about this. Hey, I'm an independent adjuster. That means I own my own business. I'm gonna dress the part. I'm gonna look professional and deal with it, right? Deal with the heat, people. Okay, but before we get into what the dress code actually is and what you should be dressing like, you should head over to Adjuster TV's YouTube channel and click the subscribe button. While you're there, hit the bell notification so you get notified every time you have a new video. And now let's go over what any adjuster, whether it's at an insurance company, an independent adjuster, an auto damage appraiser, or even a public adjuster should be dressing like so he can have the confidence of those he's working for and those he represents. But first, do you need errors and omissions, general liability, drone insurance, or even cyber liability coverage? Then let me tell you about our sponsor, Claims Professionals Liability Insurance Company, or CPLIC. Founded 16 years ago by independent adjusters, for independent adjusters, they want to give you peace of mind while you work with the insured. To apply, head over to cplic.net today. Okay, so what should you be dressing like as an independent adjuster? What is the right thing to be wearing? First off, for the most part, adjusters and appraisers are expected to wear business casual clothing. You're a business owner, so dress like it. What is business casual? For shirts, it's polo shirts and button-up shirts. You know, something like this can work if you don't like polos, that's fine. But don't be wearing t-shirts. Don't be wearing tank tops, for heaven's sake. You know, be professional. Logos and insignias for other companies or for even sports teams, probably not the best apparel to be wearing, so make sure it's as neutral as possible. They don't want to see you wearing a USA shirt and you're inspecting for somebody else, right? That's very unprofessional. The Broncos don't need represented when inspecting for Amica, right, or whoever you're inspecting for. So make sure you're as neutral as possible. Tommy Hilfiger's fine. That logo, that'll work. All right, so polos and button-up shirts. Now, also, we need to be wearing slacks. What do I mean? Slacks, as in khakis, you know, dress pants, and belts. And we need to tuck our shirts in. Now, not all carriers and IA firms and clients require that we tuck our shirts in. But you might as well make it a good practice, because don't lose work over not tucking your shirt in. That's crazy talk. Like, why would we risk it all just so we could have a shirt untucked? It's not worth it. And the insured who you're going out there for, although they're not directly paying you, if you're not giving them amazing service, if you're not seriously blowing them away with your professionalism and your dress, if you're not giving them confidence in the way they're handling you're handling their claim, guess what? They're going to contact somebody and tell them, this guy was a slouch. He came in here in flip-flops. He came in here in a t-shirt and shorts. And I don't appreciate being treated with that kind of disrespect from my insurance company, who they're paying money to month after month. Get it straight. Wear business casual clothing. Have professional shoes. Now, there's a debate whether, you know, you can wear sneakers or something like that. But I always err on the side of professionalism. So go with some business style shoes. Don't be wearing Nikes, okay? Don't be doing that. If you're on a cat line, you might be a little different scenario because you're on your feet for 12 hours a day, standing on concrete, but clear it with whoever you're working for at that point. But be professional. That's the point. Now, it's summer, right? And it's freaking hot. And I get that it's hot. Look at me. I'm pouring sweat here in Florida. And it is hot. And that is all for you guys for this video. To understand that I get what you're going through. I understand it. But we as business owners must make a difference. We must make a difference in the way we're handling claims and do better than what we're currently doing. If I've heard about it twice in 7 days, how many times has the carrier heard about it this year? What is that going to do to us as independent adjusters? Your professionalism as a business owner is imperative. A few other ways we can look professional as we come up. Typically, hats are not accepted. Hats are not generally, you know, especially sports team caps and everything are not usually standard dress code. So just skip the hat, you know, skip the hat. Don't do that, right? Make sure your car looks clean and professional. I've driven some pretty crappy cars in my time. And if you're not showing up looking professional in your car or the way your car is in appearance, even when you open your door, if it just looks like it's full of trash and stuff, guess what? That's going to hurt you. It's going to hurt your appearance. It's going to hurt the brand of independent adjusters. And I can tell you from personal experience that that's not appreciated by people. And I had to learn that, right? So I'm telling you now, be professional. I'm not saying you got to go have a brand new 2020 Ford Edge or whatever. You don't have to have a brand new car. Not at all. I never had new cars in my life. But you can have a professional car. You can keep it clean. You can keep it straight. And everything in your appearance, from the way your shirt's tucked in, from your shoes to your shirts to your slacks to your car to the notes to your email communication to your statuses to the way you communicate with the owner on the phone and through text message if need be, all of that is a part of your professionalism. And as a professional, why would you want to do anything different? You can have a great career as an IA. You can have an amazing career as an independent adjuster or as an auto damage appraiser. But if you're not professional, if you're not accepting conflict with positivity, if you're just arguing with people the first chance you get, if you're wearing shorts and sandals to an inspection, then goodness, yeah, you're not going to have a great career. So put a little effort into it. Give a little more discomfort so someone else can feel more comfortable. It's not all about you. It's not all about me. And we need to put the professionalism out in front in all aspects of our business. So today's message is pretty straightforward. So get some pants on. If you're interested in becoming an auto damage appraiser or an independent adjuster, head on over to iapath.com and click the How to Find Work button. We'll give you a free video course that walks you through exactly how this industry works, give you a step-by-step game plan and roadmap of how to get work. Thank you guys so much for watching the Auto IA Show, and until next week, keep walking your path and claiming your life.